The population in the non-government-controlled areas of Donbas is not a homogenous group. There is a sizable number of individuals, probably half, probably slightly less or slightly more, that do think of themselves as Ukrainians in terms of their ethnicity, in terms of their mother tongue, in terms of their motherland and their state. And when asked about whether they would like to reintegrate into Ukraine, they usually answer, what do you mean? We live in Ukraine. And they regard the separation that de facto happened as unjust, as imposed on them, and as artificial. Of course, there is a group of population that can be called pro-Russian, but this also means different things to different people. Some are ethnic Russians, others are Russian speakers and consider Russian as their mother tongue, and yet others do like the political system of Russia today. So the ratio between these two groups is far from being a majority and a minority. In my view, it's closer to 50-50. The population of the non-government controlled areas, the civilian population, most importantly, they have lived through a very bad war, and they do have firsthand experience of losing their loved ones, of being shelled, of spending their time with little kids in the basement, not having enough food, medicine, and this creates their experience that makes them bitter in relation to Ukraine. It is not necessarily the Russian propaganda. However, as any media, any television, Russian television, of course, frames this event in a particular way, sort of helping people understand and analyze their experience. However, people do not use Russian television as the only source of information there, as everyone else. They do look for alternative sources, they have internet, they watch Ukrainian TV, and so on. So it wouldn't be fair to say that all people think is fed to them by the Russian television. No, people do have their first-hand experience and do have their relatives and do use other sources of information as well.